pastor said, I am Penny Z. And first I would like to thank Pastor for inviting me to read to you from my book, The Amazing Word of God. I give God all the glory for the book, which took 5 years to write and has 50 Bible stories in it and will be available soon. Pastor asked me to read Peter, and so I give you Peter. Peter wrote letters to the Christians, praising God above, rejoicing in the Lord Jesus and God's redeeming love. He wrote that they should prepare their minds and they should be self-controlled. They should be holy and love each other. These virtues we extol. 1 Peter. Rid yourselves of all malice and hypocrisy, envy, slander, and deceit. Instead, you must crave spiritual things so your growth can be complete. We know that Jesus is the cornerstone to believers, and though precious to you all, he's the stone that causes non-believers to stumble. He's the rock that makes them fall. But you people are a chosen people, royal priesthood, holy nation. Praise God for calling you out of darkness and giving you salvation. But you must submit yourselves to authority, as Jesus told us then. For it is the will of God that by doing good, you silence talk of foolish men. Christ suffered for us and bore our sins in his body on the tree, so that we might die to sin and live in righteousness as the Lord wants us to be. And by his wounds you have been healed. You were like sheep astray, but now you've returned to the shepherd, the one who showed you the way. Wives, non-believing husbands can be won over by submissive wives when they see the behavior and the purity and the reverence of your lives. Your beauty should not come from adornment, fine clothes, gold jewelry, braided hair, but instead from the beauty of a gentle, quiet spirit, your inner selves, not what you wear. Husbands, you who receive the gracious gift of life should treat your wives as fellow heirs, treating them with respect and consideration so that nothing will hinder your prayers. And all of you should be living in harmony with one another, being humble, sympathetic, and compassionate, and loving each other as brother. Though pagans abuse you and think it is strange that believers no longer live in sin, the pagans will stand before God, who will judge and give account of themselves to him. You should offer hospitality, and above all else, treat each other with love, serving others by using whatever gifts you received from God above. And do not be surprised when you suffer for Christ or the painful trial you feel, but rejoice so that you may be overjoyed when his glory is revealed. If because of the name of Jesus you're insulted, you are truly blessed, for the Spirit of glory and of God upon you rests. You elders, be shepherds of God's flock, for the flock is under your care. You should be serving as overseers for the younger Christians there. Because you are willing, not because you must, is how God wants you to be. Eager to serve and not greedy for money, for the younger ones will see. So instead of lording it over them, be examples every day. When Jesus appears, you'll receive a crown of glory that will never fade away. Young men, be submissive to the elders and clothed in humility. For God resists the proud and gives peace to the humble. These words can set men free. So humble yourselves under God's mighty hand. He will lift you when time is due and cast all of your cares upon him because he cares for you. Always be self-controlled and alert every day and every hour, for the devil prowls like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Resist the devil and stand strong in the faith, for you know that there are others all over the world, and the same kind of suffering is happening to your brothers. 2 Peter. You all know the divine power of God gave us everything we need for life and godliness through our knowledge of Jesus, for it was through his deed. He gave his great and precious promises through which you can take part, in his divine nature and escape corruption caused by evil desires of the heart. Make every effort to add to your faith these things that I speak of: goodness, knowledge, self-control, perseverance, godliness, kindness, and love. For if you have these qualities in increasing measure, increasing throughout your life, they will keep you from being unproductive in your knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But if anyone does not possess these qualities, he is nearsighted and blind, and has forgotten that he's been cleansed from sin. It is important to keep this in mind. And always remember that we do not follow a cleverly written story, for we witness the voice that came to Jesus from the majestic glory, saying, "This is my Son, whom I love. With our own ears we heard. With him I am well pleased," said the voice. We were there when this occurred. And remember to pay attention to the prophets, for prophecy wasn't wrong. The message of the prophets came from God as the Holy Spirit carried them along. But there are also false prophets and teachers, and they are there with you. They preach heresy and deny the sovereign Lord, bringing destruction on themselves too. In their greed, these teachers will exploit you with stories they have made, but condemnation is hanging over them. For their sins, they will be paid. God did not spare the angels when they sinned, but sent them straight to hell. And in the day of Noah, God sent a flood, condemning those sinners as well. Yet at that time, he protected Noah and others. And when Sodom he condemned, a righteous man Lot and his family lived there. And yes, the Lord spared them. For the Lord knows how to rescue the godly, while at the very same time, he can judge and punish the unrighteous ones for their evil lives of crime. Bold and arrogant, these men are not afraid to slander a celestial being. Yet powerful angels wouldn't do such a thing in the presence of the Lord seeing. But these men go and blaspheme in matters they don't even understand. They will be paid for the harm they have done, punished by God's hand. These men carouse in broad daylight, reveling in their pleasures. With eyes full of adultery, they continuously sin. On them, he will use strong measures. And for those who have known our Lord and Savior, and then turn back to sin, it would be better for them to have not known righteousness than to turn their back on him. The day of the Lord. You must understand that in the last days, scoffers indeed will come, saying, "Where is the promise of his coming?" Mocking the Holy One. They will say that since the beginning of creation, all things are the same as then. But as God used a flood, now fire is reserved to destroy these ungodly men. But with the Lord, a day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years like a day. He is not slow in keeping his promise, but patient, not wanting anyone to pass away. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, surprising everyone there. The heavens will disappear, the elements will burn, everything on earth laid bare. And since everything will be destroyed in this way, what kind of people ought you to be? You ought to live lives that are holy and godly, and trying to make you see. For the heavens will be destroyed by fire, the elements will melt. Yet we look forward to his promise of a new heaven and earth after his judgment has been dealt. So try hard to be blameless and at peace with him, since this you look forward to. Remember the patience of the Lord means salvation, and Paul also wrote that to you. So, dear friends, do not be deceived by sinners, and drop your guard, never. But grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord. To him be the glory forever.
God bless you.